Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we shall study distributions with small variability but different centers. Here we'll study about two distributions with small variability but there is a difference in their centers. Although the distributions might seem to overlap each other, but the heights of bars in dot plots show the difference between the two distributions. Let us consider the following illustration. A class consists of 17 boys and 17 girls. They were asked how many times they go for an outing with their families in a month. Then girls and boys data was recorded separately and we can see that the variation in girls data is less. Similarly, variation in boys data is also less. So we can say that both the data have similar variability. Also, the data seems to be more or less similar to each other. Thus, data might seem to overlap with similar variation. So, is the data more or less same for both boys and girls? How can we find out? For this, we can see the center for both the series. Now, let us draw a dot plot for both series. First, we shall draw dot plot for girls. As we can see that 2 occurs 3 times in the girls series. So, we mark 2 3 times. 3 occurs 3 times, so we mark 3 times. Similarly, 4 occurs 5 times, so we mark 4 5 times. So, we mark 5 3 times and 6 also occurs 3 times. So, we mark 6 3 times. So, here we get the required dot plot for girls. Now, we shall draw the dot plot for boys. Here in the boys series, we see that 3 occurs once. So, we mark 3 once. 4 occurs 3 times. So, we mark 4 3 times. 5 occurs 2 times. So, we mark 5 twice. And we also see that 6 occurs 4 times. 7 occurs 3 times. And 8 occurs 4 times. So we mark 6 4 times, 7 3 times and we mark 8 4 times and therefore we get the required dot plot for boys and clearly we can see the difference in height of the bars in two graphs. And in the girls dot plot the center is 4, whereas in the boys dot plot graph the center is given by 6. So we can say that they have similar variability but their centers are different. Looking at the distribution of the data sets, we can observe that there is some overlap in the two data sets. Some boys and girls have both gone on outing with their families 3, 4, 5 or 6 times. Like one boy and three girls went for outing 3 times. Three boys and 5 girls went for 4 times in a month. Two boys and three girls went for 5 times and four boys and three girls went for outing 6 times in a month. Now we use mean as the measure of center. And absolute mean deviation as the measure of variation to compare two data sets. Now we shall first calculate mean for girls series, and we know that mean is given by sum of all the observations divided by the total number of observations. So here we have 4 plus 2 plus 2 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 5 plus 6 plus 4 plus 3 plus 6 plus 4 plus 5 plus 3 plus 4 plus 6 plus 5 divided by the total number of observations, which is equal to 17, which is equal to 68 by 17, that is equal to 4. For girls series we got the mean, which is equal to 4. Now we shall find out mean absolute deviation with the help of this mean. And now we shall calculate mean absolute deviation with the help of the following table. First we shall find deviation, which is given by value minus mean. So we have mean as 4 and therefore we get 4 minus 4, which is 0, 2 minus 4 minus 2, 2 minus 4 minus 2, 4 minus 4 0, 3 minus 4 minus 1, 2 minus 4 minus 2, 5 minus 4 1, 6 minus 4 2, 4 minus 4 0, 3 minus 4 minus 1, 6 minus 4 2, 4 minus 4 0, 5 minus 4 1, 3 minus 4 minus 1, 4 minus 4 0, 6 minus 4 2, 5 minus 4 is 1. And absolute deviations are given by taking modulus of deviations. So we get 0. Modulus of minus 2 is 2. And similarly, we get all the values. Mean absolute deviation is given by sum of absolute deviations from mean divided by the total number of observations which is given here as 17, and here sum of absolute deviations from mean is equal to 2 plus 2 plus 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus 1, which is equal to 18 divided by 17, and we get 1.06. So for Gerd series we get mean as 4 and mean absolute deviation is equal to 1.06. Similarly, we shall find mean and mean absolute deviation for boys, and we know that mean is given by sum of all the observations divided by total number of observations, and if we add all the numbers in the boys series, that is 4 plus 3 plus 5 plus 6 plus 8 plus 7 plus 5 plus 8 plus 4 plus 8 plus 6 plus 7 plus 6 plus 8 plus 4 plus 6 plus 7, and we divide it by 17, that is the number of observations, and we get the sum as 102 divided by 17, and therefore we get the mean as 6. Now we shall calculate mean absolute deviation for boys with the help of this mean. We know that the value of mean is given as 6. Here we shall calculate deviations, which is given by value minus mean. So we get 4 minus 6, that is minus 2, 3 minus 6, minus 3, 5 minus 6, minus 1, 6 minus 6, 0, 8 minus 6, 2, 7 minus 6 is 1, 5 minus 6 is minus 1, 8 minus 6 will be 2, 4 minus 6 is minus 2, 8 minus 6 is 2, 6 minus 6, 0, 7 minus 6, 1, 6 minus 6, 0, 8 minus 6, 2, 4 minus 6, minus 2, 6 minus 6, 0, and 7 minus 6 is 1. And absolute deviations are given by taking modulus of deviations. So we get 2, 3, 1, 0, 2, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 0, 1, 0, 2, 2, 0, and 1. We know that mean absolute deviation is given by sum of absolute deviations from mean, divided by total number of observations, which is given here as 17. Here, sum of absolute deviations from mean is given by 2 plus 3 plus 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1, and we get 22 divided by 17, which is equal to 1.3. So here for boys mean is equal to 6 and mean absolute deviation is equal to 1.3. So we can say mean absolute deviation in both the series is around 1, as it is 1.06 for girls and 1.3 for boys. So we can say that mean absolute deviation in both the series is around 1. consider difference of means is equal to 6 minus 4, that is 2. So here we can say that difference in their centers is approximately 2x the variation in each distribution . This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.